The Strangers, Chapter 1, is a new film in the Strangers franchise, which began back in 2008 with The Strangers, a simple but creepy home invasion flick that takes horror to more realistic levels, focusing on Liv Tyler and Scott Speedman's characters who are both terrorized by a trio of masked strangers who break into their home, try to, and eventually succeed in killing them. It's interesting to note that there have always been quality home invasion horror films, from Funny Games, to Inside, to Martyrs, and The Purge, each with their own unique spin on the genre. In The Purge, it's almost a neo-dystopia. In Funny Games, it's a meta and fourth wall-breaking pitch-black satire on gore in horror movies. In Barbarian, there's bits of humor. In Hush, it's a home invasion film with a twist. The twist is the protagonist is blind, so she must use her other senses to detect and stop the killer. But in The Strangers, it's very simple. What you see is what you get. A bunch of masked strangers try to murder a bland white couple in their home, and that's it. And it's creepy, I guess. Roger Ebert, arguably one of the greatest film critics of all time, gave a somewhat negative review of the film, but he was a goat enough to give some credit of admiration to the film's director, Brian Bertino. The Strangers was, after all, his feature debut, and Roger Ebert saw that and recognized his passion and his competence to make more horror films, so he gave The Strangers 1.5 stars instead of 1, and he said, I quote, "I think a lot of audience members will walk out really angry at the ending, although it has a certain truthfulness and doesn't cheat on the situation that has been building up. The movie deserves more stars for its bottom line craft, but all the craft in the world can't redeem its story," end of quote. And I think the same applies to this new Strangers film. I saw Strangers Pray at Night back in 2018, which was, oddly enough, the only sequel before this movie prequel came out. Yeah, there's only been 3 entries in the Strangers franchise, and that's from 2008 to 2024. I mean, that's a long range. That's like 16 years, and we've only gotten like 3 movies. You'd think there'd be 8 movies. And that film, Strangers Pray at Night, was pretty good, probably the best in this franchise at the time. And sadly, after Chapter 1, it still is. It had strong characters with arcs that were somewhat grounded and had a relatability to them. A brother and sister dynamic, who go on a road trip with their 2 bickering parents, and an interesting set piece at a trailer park where the family must put aside their differences to stop a masked trio of strangers who randomly attack them there. There's a simplicity to it that worked and meshed with the original action scenes. It even had some striking imagery with cool uses of music and set design that made that film memorable. Cut to the present day, Hollywood relies on IP and sequels and audiences' familiarity with pre-existing franchises in order to make a buck. The business of making good movies now is incredibly risky because big studios aren't willing to spend big bucks on original ideas. They need a formula that's already been proven to work, and franchise titles that have already had success attributed to them. It's a much safer business decision than to make a film that already has an audience, as opposed to making stories based on original ideas, and the failures of original blockbusters like recently The Creator and The Fall Guy proved this. That's why all superhero movies that now come out are pretty much the same, and why people have stopped caring. And I'll admit, when I first saw the trailer for The Strangers Chapter 1, I said, oh boy, what a load of shit. I mean, I actually laughed. It just looked so bad. The tagline said, witness how the strangers became the strangers. And a part of me said, okay, now this sounds really stupid. It sounds like Hollywood's really running out of ideas. Isn't the whole mystery of the strangers supposed to be intriguing, that these creepy masked people we don't even know who are behind the mask just attack people randomly? Or how they became what they are? I don't know. The title Chapter 1 also made it seem like there's going to be some prequel, kind of akin to Rob Zombie's Halloween remake, where we spend a considerable amount of time on the villain's origin story and see how they got to where they were. I give the movie credit for doing something that no film in the franchise is doing before, and I thought maybe The Strangers Chapter 1 would do something similar. I didn't want to have that mystery taken away from The Strangers, but I thought, okay, this could be a new angle. Let's see what they do. And the answer to what the movie does new is nothing. It's shit. This new Strangers film is so bad, I'll save your time, and I won't do a deep dive breakdown simply because the movie is so awful, slow-paced, or lacking in anything new or innovative for not only the franchise, but for the genre as a whole. It single-handedly might be one of the worst studio releases of the year so far. I was willing to give this movie credit in its first 10 minutes. It was cheesy, almost like a B-grade horror film, and so obvious with setting up its characters and plot, I thought, okay, this must be intentional. This can't be what the filmmaker actually thought would be intriguing. It has to be almost a meta play on horror stories, right? But then the rest of the film happened, and I realized, oh shit, they're for real. This is what the rest of the film will be like. Oh boy. So today, let's go into what The Strangers does wrong, and hopefully we can explore some lessons for how to make your horror film better than this, and how you can make a prequel to a pretty well-known scary movie franchise without making it a piece of shit. So The Strangers opens with our two main characters, Maya and Ryan, the most bland and uninteresting characters imaginable, driving to their vacation house in the woods. And right off the bat, it's so bad. I'll say this, the film has no unique hook, no sick cold open, nothing that really grabs you and lets you know the movie will be a fun time, which it isn't. The movie just plops you down and expects you to roll with it, and it's just such a boring choice. Whereas, look at The Strangers Pray at Night. The movie opens with this couple who own the trailer park, and we watch in suspense as they are picked off one by one before the film rolls its title card and we get to meet our main characters. The movie gives us horror and dread, something to fear and be on the lookout for, before we even meet the protagonist. It's the simplest thing a movie can do, but for whatever reason, this film just doesn't do that. It does. It's just so quick and stupid, I literally forgot. Yeah, that's right. The movie actually does open with a guy crawling away in the woods before he has an axe taken him, but like, it just comes out of nowhere. There's no dread, no suspense. The movie just starts with this guy crawling away in the woods and he gets an axe in his head. Like, at least build that up. At least build up the sense of dread. I don't just care if it's just some guy running in the woods. What is he running from? Obviously, someone's chasing him. It's just so bland, and I think it just perfectly represents how the movie is doing the littlest thing possible.
Like, if we compare the opening to Get Out, that movie actually has a great opening. Why? It's creepy. It lets you build up to the moment where this man is abducted. You get to see him, his personal relationship. You see him on the phone. You can tell he's worried. You can tell he's worried something actually might happen. There's actually dread here. And then it pays off later when you find out what happened to him. It isn't just leaving this as some random scene. It has purpose that pays off later. The Strangers just doesn't do this.
So right after this instantly forgettable and quick cold open, it cuts down to Maya and Ryan, who, let me stress this, are seriously the most bland characters imaginable in a horror film. They just have no character. I really did not like them. They're on this road trip, and the exposition is just awful. Maya's in the car, pretending to speak into a microphone as if she's doing some fucking podcast interview. And she's just stating, oh, I'm with my boyfriend who hasn't proposed to me yet. Oh, I'm an architect, by the way, and my boyfriend is taking me on this trip. Which, by the way, is barely integral to the plot. And one scene later, she notices the house they're staying in is a crawl space because she's an architect, I guess. But this obvious exposition is just so unneeded and just forced. The movie's just one big tease. They go into this town where the townspeople are basically dicks to them for no reason. They meet a mechanic who offers to fix their tire, and they accuse him of sabotaging the tire to try and make a buck at his garage. They think the waitress is in on it too, and the unfriendly diner manager. But like, it never comes back at all. These characters are really never seen again, so what's the point? Sure, you're thinking, oh, these people are going to come back to stalk them later. Maybe they are the Strangers. But this never happens. The people who antagonize them and act very suspicious towards Maya and Ryan don't do shit. They just appear creepy and slink back into the shadows. Like, what the fuck? It's one big tease. Which is a great way of describing the whole movie. And to top it off, there's no conflict. Nothing between Maya and Ryan that really makes them interesting as a couple or worth following. Or having any real investment in. There's nothing grounded or real seeming about their relationship, down to their arguments. Ryan wants to go to a motel they booked, and Maya wants to stay at this Airbnb recommended by the waitress. She accuses Ryan of being too uptight, and he accuses her of being clueless. But the conflict between them is just built on nothing and just evaporates like one scene later. It doesn't add up to anything meaningful in context or scenes that would add tension or thrills. There's nothing you can relate to with this couple protagonist. Like, if there was something they could bond over, like, I don't know, maybe they find a dog and in the woods and they want to protect him, or the guy's like, oh, I don't want to take care of this dog, and she's like, oh, but the dog's so cute. I don't know, that would just be better. Like, give the movie something worth latching onto. We need something relatable. Them just bickering over where they're gonna stay is so stupid. It doesn't add to anything. Like, Maya's cluelessness doesn't really do anything further to fuel the tension. She doesn't leave a door unlocked. She doesn't forget something important. She's just a stupid character who acts super calm all the time, even when people are trying to break into their homes. Same with Ryan. He just has the same frustrated approach to the situations they find themselves in, and it just makes no sense. The character should get increasingly scared or worried if people are trying to break in, but it just doesn't happen. They're oddly relaxed for people facing a home invasion. My friend and I saw the movie, and we were making fun of Madeline Patch's facial expressions throughout the movie. For someone who's having her house broken into in the woods by masked strangers with weapons, she seems oddly relaxed and more annoyed and not afraid. The audience is afraid when the characters are afraid, and the characters in this are just never really afraid, so why should we even care? Another thing that sucks about this movie is how obvious it is. I hate the use of insert shots. And immediately, this was a red flag that the movie would suck. There's these obvious cuts when they're at the diner, two missing posters on the wall. Just showing it once, sure, it's fine, you know, someone's missing. It's creepy. It makes you wonder, like, oh, is that coming back again? That's kind of creepy. But then the movie just cuts back to it and, like, zooms in on this missing poster. And it's just so fucking obvious and a clear indicator that the movie doesn't trust the audience. Just show the thing once. Don't rub it in our faces. That's how you take away the scariness. I like a sense of mystery. Leave a little desire to know who it is that's missing. Don't keep cutting back and showing us. It takes away from the horror. It's like saying, don't worry, guys. The horror is coming. This is just a prelude. And the same goes for another obvious plot device, like Ryan's inhaler. Oh my god. I hate inhalers in horror films. It's just such an obvious choice for a plot device. It's like when a character is sick and has medicine they need, and it's like, oh, I left the medicine. Like, no, it's just so overused. And the movie barely hides this. Maya's character says to him multiple times, oh babe, don't forget your inhaler. Don't you need that? And it's like, fuck. Why does this film want to be so damn obvious? The film also cuts to the inhaler in their, like, cup holder, indicating he left it. Like, chill the fuck out with the insert shots. We get it. It's so obvious. If you have something important, hint at it or subtly suggest it. Use non-straightforward dialogue to explain the conflict instead of just straight up telling us he needs the inhaler. Like, maybe have him leave it once or use it once and then leave it in the diner. And maybe Maya and Ryan see some other guy break into their car. Ryan runs after this guy who broke into their car. Have Ryan get winded, go to use his inhaler and put it away, and don't bring it up again. Then you have tension, you have a reason to use this plot device, and it's so much better than just stating obvious dialogue, which takes away from the film. Just do anything but say the obvious plot information. It takes you out of the movie and makes it less scary and feel, even worse, less real. To me, however, one of the biggest issues and one of the most criminal with Strangers Chapter 1 is just that it's not scary in the simplest way possible. It fails on unimaginable levels. It has so much potential to frighten you, yet it just doesn't. There's a line in this film where Maya and Ryan see a woman standing outside their window. Ryan asks what she's doing, and Maya says, she's just standing there. And that describes this whole movie. It's so bad, mostly because the villains don't do shit. They just stand there. I'll give it that earlier on, there's one creepy bit of tension where a woman who's, like, masked in shadow knocks on the door several times and asks if a woman named Tamara lives there. And yeah, this scene is creepy. It has this ominous setting where you don't know who this woman is. She's just in shadow knocking at their door. She leaves and come back, and she asks the same question, and then just stands in the driveway before being chased off. Sadly, this is, like, one of the only moments of tension that works, and then when they repeat it, it's honestly kind of funny because she's just standing there in their driveway. You're like, how many times are they gonna try this? It's like, it just is weird at this point. And it's fairly obvious. Yeah, creepy woman in the shadows who we can't see asking about the house is creepy. But sadly, this type of tension is barely used or brought up again. The rest of the film just follows these three masked strangers who are trying to break into Maya and Ryan's house and trying to terrorize them. But that's just it. They don't even terrorize them. The strangers just kind of appear and stare for a bit, and then Maya and Ryan run. And the strangers literally don't do shit. It's literally like an episode of Scooby-Doo, where they're running, like, through all the doors and the strangers are just standing there. It's like the main characters who are the ones driving the actions, not the villains, which is just so boring. If you're gonna have these three masked strangers break into their house, at least have them try and intimidate them. Have them taunt them and chase them and hide in places you would not expect. Having one of the strangers hum a creepy nursery rhyme and hide in a closet and just stare at Maya is not enough. It kind of exemplifies what is broken with this whole movie. See, the strangers just don't have a goal. They have no motivation, and I guess the goal is to find this couple, tie them up, and kill them. But the lack of a drive on both sides is what really brings this movie down. Like, there's a moment early on where the strangers find them, tie them up, and just leave them in a room, but they don't do anything with that. They're just standing outside the door, where Maya and Ryan have plenty of time to talk and plan an escape. This really brings out a boring escape sequence where we spend like 10 minutes watching Maya and Ryan get out of their binds, climb into the crawl space, which thankfully Maya is an architect, so she knows this. They make their way under the house outside before there's this one moment of tension where she gets her hand stuck on a nail, so we have to spend a couple of minutes taking it out. It's just so boring. And then once they finally get out from under the house, of course the strangers are right there. Once again, they don't do anything. The strangers are not the prime focus, it's Maya trying to get a nail out of her hand. Like, that's not what you paid to go see The Strangers Chapter 1 for. I don't care about someone trying to pull a nail out of their hand. I want to see The Strangers. And then they're just standing there and burning their motorcycle. Like, okay, now they can't use that as a method of escape. And even once they burn the motorcycle, they just stand there and they don't chase Maya and Ryan. The strangers just split up and take turns appearing in random sections of the house to creep them out. And Maya and Ryan are also so stupid because they keep splitting up. But the movie would be smart if it acknowledged it's a bad idea to split up. They're stronger together, but it just doesn't acknowledge this. So when they do split up, it feels like it could work. Just give your characters a pre-existing basis to make it work. have Ryan get injured. This does happen later on, but it's far too late in the movie to warrant their decision to split up. I think my main issue with this is that the film, the strangers just don't do anything. I was honestly pretty frustrated seeing people saying they thought this movie was all right, because it really isn't all right. I saw someone saying it was a solid 6 out of 10, and I'm like, bro, this movie's honestly really terrible and boring. If you think this is a good horror movie, I don't know what you think is like great. If you were going to make a horror movie, let alone a home invasion horror movie, there are several rules. You should follow the characters who are breaking in. They need to have a clear goal, even if it's just to terrorize you. You don't need to establish that right away. We don't learn that until the final moments. They are on screen. All they do is stand and stare and watch them instead of actually making an effort to scare or terrorize them. We need to feel that these strangers are brutal, that they are killers without remorse or without heart. Just having them walk around the house with weapons doesn't do shit. You actually need to show them having this desire to hurt. Also, you need to add in other characters to broaden the story. About halfway through the movie, a random dude shows up on the porch and Ryan fatally shoots him with a shotgun, and then Maya just goes, "Oh, that's the house owner who rented this to us." Because we've never seen this house owner before, and Maya just says, "Oh, that's the guy who rented us the property," it leaves virtually no impact. We have no idea who this guy is, and now he's dead. It doesn't matter at all. If perhaps one of the townspeople showed up who we had already met, maybe there'd be some sort of impact. One of the townspeople come back in to check on them and then end up getting killed. But instead, it's just this boring cat and mouse game between these two bland protagonists and these three even more surprisingly bland killers. It just left me wanting some kind of dread. I think a perfect example of a movie that does this concept better is the French movie Inside from 2007. It's 80 minutes, so it's just 7 minutes shorter than this. And it has so much more. The movie has a home invasion premise where a single pregnant mother is home alone and being stalked by a terrifying woman who wants to break into her house and steal her baby from her womb. And just the premise alone is terrifying, but it's how the movie goes about building up the tension that makes it so well. The first 10 minutes, we meet this crazy stalker lady, and we see her outside the house, and she doesn't just stand there like the strangers do. She's actually actively trying to stalk her and break into the house. She immediately breaks in and tries to execute her goal of taking the baby, but she fails, and the result is this brutal cat and mouse game between the two. Then you add in that there are other characters who get caught in the crossfire, such as the pregnant woman's mother and cops and neighbors. The film just keeps escalating and adding things on, and it really feels terrifying. As a result, this movie just takes place in a vacuum, the strangers. There's like 5 characters with no personalities, and it's almost like we're on this endless Ferris wheel that just goes nowhere. It's not even a roller coaster, it's just the boring same thing going on over and over, and you know what's gonna happen every time. There's no surprises, no scares. When you have no scares in your horror movie, it's absolutely going to suck. Look at Inside, the movie just keeps escalating. There's always something different happening. There's always another way this stalker woman is trying to kill this woman or take her baby. The woman who's trying to save her baby always is coming up with a new way to try and escape from this woman. And then there's other things going on, like she gets injured, she has to defend herself, she has to hide in a bathroom, the stalker woman is coming after her. Like, I would really watch Inside and see how it's so much better than Strangers Chapter 1. Also, that movie is pretty violent, but you don't even need to make your movie so violent, just have that tension that this movie does not have. And then, on top of that, this movie is called Strangers Chapter 1, yet it really does nothing new to add to this franchise. Like I said, I get it earlier, they're just trying to keep the mystery of who the strangers are kind of hidden after all the intrigue. They are just these masked people, but it honestly would have worked a little better, at least in this case, if the movie revealed that the waitress or the mechanic from earlier were actually the strangers. Like, it just would have made things come full circle instead of just randomly having them kill them at the end and leaving it like, it's just such an unsatisfying ending. I mean, I get it, they're trying to make this Strangers Chapter 1. They're not gonna call it, I don't know, Strangers Ride or Die, like the new Bad Boys movie. But like, just do something with your title. If you're gonna call it Strangers Chapter 1, have a little bit of a prequel element there. Now, the killer has been more brutal or more straightforward in their attempt to do this earlier, or maybe the ending would have felt more earned. But as it is, it just feels incredibly lackluster. Not to mention, the opening of the film describes this as one of the most brutal crimes in America, yet there's almost virtually no violence until the very end. I think the opening text that scrolls across the screen is honestly a bit interesting. It kind of leaves you feeling like, ooh, this is a true documentary. And it kind of leaves you with dread, honestly. I'll admit, the first minute of this movie, I thought, this is creepy. But I wish it kept some of that promise, but it doesn't, and as a result, the movie is just terrible.